Hey there! In today's video, we're diving right into a practical introduction to the Google Cloud Marketplace and associated concepts. This marketplace exists as your one-stop shop for acquiring third-party software or tools that you may need for building your software solutions. So, you can expect to find popular software services like Elasticsearch, Kafka, and MongoDB, along with thousands of other offerings. But how exactly do these offerings surface in the marketplace? Well, let's explore that together. Say we navigate to Databricks. What you'll find here is a neat pricing structure that you can subscribe to. They've made it incredibly transparent. You can easily see how much you'll be charged and take advantage of a pay-as-you-go pricing model without needing to deal directly with Databricks. Not all offerings work this way, though. Another approach is private pricing. Take Snowflake as an example. There's no public pricing available here. Instead, you'll need to contact the vendor through the marketplace. They'll then design a custom offer just for you, usually for premium offerings and enterprise pricing. But let's circle back to Databricks for a moment. Let's delve into how these marketplace offerings actually work. To subscribe to Databricks, you'll need certain permissions. If you manage to get the procurement orders place permission on your billing account, you're good to go. I'm adding that permission off screen. Do note though, permission propagation can take a little while. On this subscription page, you can see the features that are enabled and see a reminder about the pricing. You might spy a pricing calculator on the right-hand side, but remember, this is just an estimation. You aren't tied to it, but rather will be billed with a pay-as-you-go pricing. So, up next, select our billing account, give a nod to the terms, and voila, we're ready to subscribe. Next, we'll have this link to the Databricks setup page waiting, where we simply have to sign in with our account. At Databricks.com, we note that the service is deeply interconnected. By creating a workspace, selecting a region and a project, we get an OAuth integration to manage Compute Engine resources. Although Databricks is a managed SaaS, we still leverage this connection to our projects for important tasks like setting up Databricks clusters. Finally, to bring this scenario to life, we'll go into our workspace. You can see the concept when we start creating Compute in our project. Note that these aren't just any machine configurations, they're Google Cloud CPU types that will be deployed in our project in our Google Cloud tenant. The marketplace offering provides the SaaS control plane, but ties into our Google Cloud instance. So, unless we start creating resources with this Databricks instance, we won't even see these resources in our project. Moving on, let's spot the Databricks workspace VMs. Now let's return to the marketplace page to explore another type of offering. Remember, the standard and fan favorite choice in marketplace is SaaS and APIs. This is where we discover Databricks. However, there's another approach if you prefer hands-on control, where we deploy in our own tenant as opposed to a managed environment like Databricks. Interested? Let's change the category and explore things like virtual machines or Kubernetes apps instead of SaaS and APIs. Intrigued? Let's dig in with virtual machines using Bitnami VM for RabbitMQ, shall we? Let's take a quick glance at the estimated cost for the infrastructure as we auto-deploy with this marketplace offer. No additional usage fees here, so this is perfect for introducing yourself to the concept. Time to agree, proceed, and now, drumroll, deploy. This all sounds very technical, but trust me, it's as simple as choosing the deployment name, the deployment size, and a few configuration options. Then we're all set to deploy this out to Compute Engine. Before we end, let's touch on how you can dismantle these deployments once you're done with them. Let's dive back into our RabbitMQ for example. From the deployment manager, we can halt or delete the deployment. So in summary, we have both transparent pricing offerings and private pricing offers with SaaS managed implementations or in-tenant VM or GKE deployments. We'll be closely monitoring the comment section for any questions. Thank you for watching and please enjoy responsibly.